Science and Technology, Computing Devices, Grade 5. Today, we shall learn about how to use the keyboard to type text in a Word document. In the last lesson, we learned about how to open a new Word document in Microsoft Office Word Processor. But today, as I've said, we are going to learn about using the keyboard to type text and edit text. Now, in front of us, we have the screen and we have a picture or an image of the keyboard, and we are going to examine various parts of the keyboard, various keys which you use when you are retyping text in the Word document. We shall start by looking at the caps lock key, which is found here. Caps lock key. The caps lock key enables a user to type in capital letters. So when you want to type capital letters, you use the caps lock. You put it, you press on it. And when you do that, you are able to type your letters as capital letters. For example, if I press the caps lock, I can type what I want to type in capital letters. For example, the word Kenya. It is typed and it is in capital letters. Now, if I want to type my text in small letters, what do I do? I press again on the caps lock. So when I press on the caps lock and I type again, I will have that word appearing there in small letters. So that's how we use the caps lock key. Another key that we use on the keyboard is the space bar. The space bar is here at the bottom, and it is used for creating space between words. Let me write the word my country. I've written my, but I want space. So to create space, I'll press the space bar like that. I can write country. So that's how we can use the space bar to create space between words. Another key that is important here is the enter key. It is found here. It is also found at the bottom right here. So the enter key is used to move the cursor to the next line. So right now, my cursor is there. I want to go to the next line. So when I press enter, the cursor moves to the next line. So I'm able to type text in the next line. So I can write, I love my country, Kenya. So that's how I can use the enter key to move to the next line. And the next one, the next key is the delete key, which is found here. This is the delete key. The delete key is used for erasing any letters or numbers which appear after the cursor. So let me put my cursor here. I love my country, Kenya. So I put my cursor before those words. It is there. If I want to delete those words, I'll use the delete key. So I'll press the delete key like that, and those words and the number and letters, they are erased. They are being erased. So that's how we can use the delete key to erase letters or numbers which appear after the cursor. Now, another key on the keyboard is the backspace. key, which is found here, is the backspace key, and it is used to erase, or it is used for erasing letters or numbers which appear before the cursor. So let's say I put my cursor here after the word country. So all these words appear before the cursor and I want to erase them. So I use the backspace key. So I can press it and those letters and numbers and words, they are being erased. That is how we use the backspace key to erase letters or numbers appearing before the cursor. And then finally, we have the arrow keys. The arrow keys are found here. There are four of them. We have this key which faces upwards and downwards. This one faces downwards. This one faces to the right and this to the left. So the arrow keys are used for navigating the document. To navigate is just to move about in the document. So let's say that my cursor is here. Is here where I'm clicking here and I want to bring it here. So I'm going to use the arrow keys to navigate from here to this point. So I can use the down key like that. The cursor moves there like that. It moves like that. It moves. It's now there. And I want the cursor now to move to the desired point. So I'll use the right arrow key. So I press it like that. You see, now the cursor moves. The cursor moves up to where I want it to be. So it is there finally. And if I want the cursor to move upwards, I can use the arrow key facing upwards. If I want the cursor to move to the beginning of this line, then I can use the arrow key which faces to the left. So I can press like that until the cursor reaches where I want it to be. So those are the parts of the keyboard and how we use them when you're retyping text in a document.